Today's series of Docplexus KOL interviews, we have with us Dr. Mohammed Shafiq, who's the General Secretary of Indian Association of Clinical Cardiologists. Thank you, Dr. Shafiq, for this interview. So let's begin with the first question. Doctor, there are various treatment modalities in the management of cardiovascular diseases. Can you please elaborate on that?
Yeah, cardiovascular diseases, normally we start the treatment with medical management. So we have antiplatelets and statin to lead the way. And once the patient gets an acute MI, usually the modality of treatment is coronary angioplasty. And regarding patients who have extensive diseases, we have coronary artery bypass grafting, or the usually called as bypass surgery. Besides all this, there is one modality which is not extensively used, and it is called external counterpulsation. So these are the methods available for treatment of cardiovascular diseases.
So doctor, how does ECP help in preventing cardiovascular diseases?
External counterpulsation, it actually increases the collateral circulation. So how we can understand this is, when there is a blockage in the main artery, main coronary artery, a patient who undergoes this treatment, his branches of the main arteries, the interconnecting branches, that is called the collaterals. Usually they are very small branches and they supply the muscles, and some branches are from the other artery also have connections in between them. So a person who undergoes EECP, these small branches are dilated, and the interconnections or the network of arteries this increases. So there is a continuous blood supply. Even if one part of a blood vessel is blocked, blood will somehow transfuse to the other places. So it's also called as the natural bypass. That's how it is.
So moving on to the next one, how is the relevance of this system in Indian population?
In Indian population, already two or three states, the government has implemented EECP as a treatment program in the government medical colleges, mainly in Tamil Nadu and Karnataka. And in New Delhi also some hospitals follow this modality. So the government is benefited in such a way that this machine, once you implement 10 beds in a ward, the persons who are recommended ECP can just take the treatment for 1 hour per day for 35 days, and there is no extra expense or healthcare cost involved. So the government is benefited because only the initial expense is there, and then maybe the maintenance charges comes up. But a large number of patients can be catered with this treatment. And so what happens is, not only the cardiac part is taken care of. When one person undergoes this treatment, the collateral circulation to all the organs in the body increases. So in some countries like Switzerland, it's followed as a rejuvenation therapy. Even people who do not have any disease, they take up this treatment so that they are benefited in such a way that the total productivity of that person increases. For example, the mental alertness, the chance of a person getting stroke or cardiac events, then the diabetic status, because the blood supply to the pancreas increases, insulin resistance decreases due to the various hormonal balance mechanisms, and even the renal function and the sexual function of the people has been found to increase.
So thank you so much, doctor, for the interview. It was a pleasure having you here.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.